Hi guys, David and David here from payitforward.com, and in this video we're going to explain what to do when your iPad won't turn on.
When your iPad won't turn on, it's either going to be a software problem or a hardware problem. So the first thing we'll do is start by troubleshooting the software. The software crash can make it appear as if your iPad won't turn on.
Yep.
What's the fix?
Hard reset. We're going to press and hold the home button and the power button at the same time until the Apple logo appears on the screen. Usually takes about 15 seconds. Can take as long as 30 seconds though, so don't give up.
Right, so David has a healthy iPad. It's not going to take too long as he does it, but as David said, sometimes you have to hold them down for much longer than you think you should have to. A lot of people would come into the Apple store, you know, they thought they did it, they didn't do it.
So now there are really two paths we can go down here. The hard reset worked path and the hard reset didn't work path. We're going to pretend like the hard reset did work first, and we'll address if it didn't work later on in this video.
Right.
So the hard reset worked.
It worked.
What's next?
The next step is to try to prevent future software crashes, because who wants this problem to happen all the time?
Not me.
You know, one of the things with this is, like, if the hard reset works, I would just say, keep using your iPad.
Yeah.
You really only have to worry about the software stuff if it keeps happening over and over again. If it does keep happening over and over again, you're going to want to reset all settings first on your iPad. We'll show you how to do that.
Yep.
That's sort of the non-invasive software fix, because it resets everything in the Settings app, but doesn't touch any of your personal information. So,
open the Settings app. Tap General, which is already selected here. Scroll down and tap Reset. And then tap Reset All Settings. Enter your passcode, tap Reset All Settings to confirm. Reset will happen, iPad will restart, and the settings will have been reset.
Yep, and hopefully your software will be fixed, and you'll never have to do the hard reset again. If that did not work, and you're still having software issues, we would want to do a
DFU restore.
DFU restore. It's the deepest type of restore you can do on an iPad, and it is the last-ditch effort to fix any software problem. If a software fix is going to work, the DFU restore is the way to go.
We have a great DFU restore your iPhone video. It's the same steps for the iPad. We'll link to that in the description below and a card above.
So,
what if the hard reset didn't work?
If it didn't work, then we're talking about some sort of a hardware problem, possibly, but not necessarily. First step, let's check the charging port in the bottom of the iPad.
Yep.
Now, gunk can get in here, lint, debris, nuclear waste, fallout.
Probably not. Not that.
So you just want to take like a toothbrush that you've never used before, or an anti-static brush.
Which we have.
Yep. Which we have because we're nerds. Just brush it out.
Bang in there. And
yep.
Hopefully stuff
just don't
comes
use
out.
Anything metallic, because you can fry the thing, and then, you know, that's no good.
Or an old toothbrush, which is, you know, covered in your spit.
But yep, that's no good either.
So cleaned it out. It's clean. Still won't turn on.
Won't turn on.
The check is the lightning cable.
Lightning cable. So just take a look, make sure it's not frayed at any end.
Yep.
Because if it's frayed, I'm afraid it might not work.
Fortunately, this is a, you know, brand new cable.
We just pulled it out of the box. Yeah. Okay. If it doesn't look like this,
it might be
try a friend's cable.
Yep.
Brilliant.
Third thing to check is your iPad charger.
Take a look inside, make sure it works. Try a friend's charger.
Yep.
Try it in the car.
Yeah.
Try it in your laptop.
Yep.
Try it in your smart fridge.
Try it in your smart toaster.
Try it. Okay.
Yep. So try multiple chargers. If it still won't turn on,
yep.
We're going to plug our iPad into the computer and see if it's recognized by iTunes.
Because
if it is, it could just be a display issue, not a whole overall iPad hardware issue.
Yep. Maybe it's making noises too, and you're like, hey, it's making noises, but it won't turn on. Display issue. So let's try to plug it in. We'll connect the cable to the iPad.
Yep. Good work.
Okay. And then we'll connect the USB side to my laptop, which won't go in because it's one of the new MacBooks. Who needs USB ports? Not Apple. So you get to buy one of these adapters.
Great.
Lucky you. And you plug it in, and then now I can plug it into my Mac.
Excellent.
Now, David's iPad should show up in iTunes.
There it is.
Do you want to allow this computer? Yep. If you see anything show up in iTunes, we know that the hardware, sort of the guts of the iPad, are working, but the display is not.
Right.
So,
and if it is recognized by iTunes, you should really back up your iPad immediately, just in case something goes wrong and things get worse. If it's not recognized by iTunes, you're probably going to need to get your iPad repaired.
Or if it is recognized by iTunes, you're probably going to need to get your iPad repaired.
Yeah. Either way, you need to get it repaired. You have two great options. First of all, there's the Apple Store, especially if your iPad is covered by AppleCare Plus. Great option. Secondly, we recommend Pulse, a third-party repair service. I'll send a technician directly to you. Lifetime warranty. Pulse is a great repair company. We highly recommend them. and we'll leave links to both of those repair companies in the description section below. Mm-hmm. So that's what to do when your iPad won't turn on. Thank you guys for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the notification bell to get an immediate update whenever we upload a new video.